WPRI 12. It's the Rhode Show Primetime Special. Rhode Island Monthly's Best of Rhode Island. A look at all the very best the Ocean State has to offer. Live from the party of the year.
Welcome to the Rhode Show Primetime Special, Rhode Island Monthly's Best of Rhode Island. We are coming to you live this evening from PPAC for the party of the year, and we definitely had to dress the part. Myself and Megan are wearing dresses from Sonia's in Cranston.
Very
hair
nice.
And makeup were done by Percasso Salon. I even jazzed up my nails a little bit from Salon Charisma.
Yeah, you cool. You look great.
Thank
wait till you.
You
see Megan. I want to thank the Tux Shop at East Greenwich for supplying the tuxedo tonight. So we're all dressed up. We are ready for our party, and you have come to the right place. Over the next half hour, we are going to take you through some of the best Rhode Island has to offer, all voted on by you. And this year, we're taking you through some of the best spots right here in Rhode Island. Just a short time ago, guests started to arrive, and they were happy and ready to have lots of fun. And of course, we were there on all of the action to bring it to you, and there's a lot going on tonight, from food trucks to great martini bar, even live entertainment, and yes, even a silent auction.
Very nice. You know, this is just such an exciting time. This room is packed with iconic figures and Rhode Island favorites. You can see people are starting to move around now. That's because a lot of them have just been honored. Over 300 winners have received Best of Awards this evening. In fact, we are going to be showing you them by county this evening. But like I said, this is such a great honor. And everyone loves receiving a Best of Rhode Island Award.
And they look forward to it every year. And now, though, it is time for what the screaming is all about. It is time to party right here. And everyone in the room is here to celebrate tonight. And we are ready to celebrate as well.
We, of course, are ready to celebrate. So why not kick things off by starting over in Newport County.
Sounds good to me.
There. Now, if you're from Rhode Island or not, chances are you've definitely frequented the Cliff Walk. Even those hurricanes couldn't stop people from traveling down to that three-mile destination along the beach down in Newport, especially in the summertime.
Known for its breathtaking views and natural beauty, the Cliff Walk is a popular destination in Newport.
It's beautiful. The scenery is beautiful. The water is lovely. It's quiet.
It's well kept.
Yeah, it is.
It's great exercise. It's a beautiful day.
Locals and tourists can't help but take a stroll.
We were in Providence, and we heard that it was a great thing to do, so we came out to do it.
While it's most popular in the summer months, you'll still find people here all year round.
Spring, summer, winter. We do. It's a nice walk. Yeah, really pretty walk. You get to see the mansions and all the architecture, and then you've got this pretty view right here.
It's no wonder Rhode Island Monthly has named it the best free attraction in Newport County.
The view and access to the beach area, and I like seeing the mansions as we go around.
Our son comes here and he surfs as well, and this is supposed to be one of the best beaches for surfing, so we'll come down here and watch him as well.
Whether it's walking the 40 steps, taking in a good view with an ocean breeze, or catching a few rays, the Cliff Walk is for you.
It's really nice to, I guess, have the walk along the water and kind of smell the ocean.
Yeah.
Well, it's beautiful. I mean, there's places on the Cliff Walk where you can go down and jump in the water if you want to.
We took a million pictures. I love taking pictures.
So there you have it, the best free attraction in Newport. And you know what?
Yes!
The excitement has just gotten even greater.
It did.
Someone just proposed on stage.
Yeah, Jason and Andrea, I believe that's what their names were, they met. And what a better place for the big proposal. And we're assuming she said yes.
She did
yes.
Say yes. But you never know what can happen here at the Best of Rhode Island Party.
Absolutely. Now we're going to head out, check out some of the other great things. And we're going to check out with Megan Mooney. She is out in the lobby, and she was able to meet up with a lot of the VIPs. Let's toss it over to Meg.
Hey, that's right, guys. We are having so much fun. I mean, look at everybody out here. People are pouring in. And earlier in the night, we had a chance to see everything that was going on, from food trucks to VIPs that were coming in, chatted with some of them. So let's take a look. Rain or shine, the Best of Rhode Island Party happens every year. So we're outside the Providence Performing Arts Center, where people are starting to arrive and things are getting underway. So let's check it out. From a sweet frozen treat to a different kind of treat from Angela's on the Hill, they've got it all here. And restaurants from all over the state come out to showcase their best treats, and everybody loves Greg's chocolate cake. Mmm. There's even a silent auction going on, so you can put your name down for some fun things in Rhode Island, and I know what I will be doing. I'm gonna be bidding on a little Swarovski crystal, because this looks so good. Ooh, I have never been up here before. This feels fun. The stage is empty right now, but it's gonna be filled with a lot of VIPs in a little bit. We're here at the entrance of the Best of Rhode Island party tonight. I'm here with Nairobi, who just came in. Nick, who are you wearing tonight?
I'm wearing Nairobi wear, formal, casual, but it's beautiful, isn't it?
Is it cushiony?
It is. Oh yeah, this is very comfortable.
This is
comfortable wear.
Looking forward to tonight?
Looking forward to it. Always look forward to it. Rhode Island Monthly does a fantastic job.
And you've won so many years. Tell me about it.
Year after year, the perennial Best Customer Service Award. We're so excited because it really highlights our team.
Because you want to have a very nice dress for tonight, isn't that right?
Yes, and then I didn't have my necklace, so I actually made my necklace in the car on the way here.
How about that? And you guys are up for an award tonight?
Yes, we are. Very excited.
As you can tell, everyone is really looking forward to tonight, so I'm going to head inside and find out who are the winner. Having such a great time out here. Ooh, another bite of Greg's chocolate cake, or rather the lemon cake. There's gonna be more here. I'm gonna be back out, but for right now, we'll go back to you. Will, Michaela.
Oh, it looks like you're having so much fun, Meg.
It is, lots of fun. And now we're gonna check out a Providence. Just the mention of the name LaSalle Bakery, and you picture the amazing desserts.
LaSalle Bakery started in the early 1930s by Jake DeMaria. Shopped in here when I was a little boy, and then, you know, started working there as a pan boy, cleanup kid. He taught me to bake.
Little did Mike know that it would become his future.
Ended up in 1975 with my wife purchasing the bakery. The bakery has grown considerably since then to two stores, one the original on Smith and this one on Admiral. The rest of the family has joined the business, two sons, and we're at somewhere 80-something employees now, so the business has grown considerably.
Making those famous cakes is not as easy as you may think.
Well, I think we have a high standard of quality. We don't make junk.
The big question is, does he have faith I can do it?
I think you could. I have Nicole here that would be glad to show you how to decorate. She's much better at it than I am.
We've kind of modernized how we decorate our cakes. We kind of stepped a little bit away from the traditional roses and stuff like that. We've kind of gone into larger flowers like daisies and things like that, and it's been very popular. So that's one of the things we're gonna try and do today.
I may be better at eating cake than making cake.
We're kind of gonna make a dot for the center of our flower.
Okay.
And what you're gonna do is, with the thin side out, you're gonna make the petal. Not bad.
Not bad.
It can be a little further apart, but I would try and stick closer.
Okay. I don't think this is looking like a flower at all. I think she's just being nice to me. LaSalle has grown into a family.
One of the things that's really great about this is that everyone here really gets along really well. We're all like a big, giant family, so coming into work is amazing.
You're making it look so easy.
When you do hundreds of these a day, it becomes very easy. Trust me, when I first started, mine did not look like this.
Even the photographer's laughing. you know it's bad when the guy on the other side of the camera is laughing at you.
See, it's a little better.
You're lying to me.
Our cakes, we put a lot of emphasis into decorating our cakes, but not only decorating and making them beautiful, but making them taste good. We've diversified over the years, getting into the coffee business and iced coffee and drinks of that nature. Give people more reasons to come into our stores.
You always know it's a special occasion when there's a cake from LaSalle.
We've tried to be part of people's special occasions by making cakes and pastries.
The best cakes and pastries is the reason they're the best.
I'm very proud of it, and I'm very proud to share that with my whole staff. I'm sure they're all very proud of it. It's a great feeling to get that kind of validation, recognition from Rhode Island Monthly. It's very heartwarming to see that.
Oh, I could watch that over and over.
It is so funny. It really is. And everybody seems to think it's so easy to decorate these cakes till you're actually the one who's standing there trying to decorate the cake. But I have to tell you.
You made a solid effort.
I made a solid effort, and I took that cake home, and it tasted perfectly fine to me. I have no problem having that.
That's what really matters.
It is.
Right? It's a taste of it all. But I got to tell you, LaSalle Bakery, I don't care what you're getting from there. Cakes, sweets, treats. Drinks, it's all good.
Absolutely, whatever it is, and as we were saying in that piece, you know it's a special occasion. When you go to an event and someone says, oh, I got the cake at LaSalle, everybody is always like, oh.
You grab a slice.
That's a big deal, that's a big deal. So
absolutely.
We were happy to be part of that.
But you know what, Providence isn't the only area with good eats. It's summertime in Rhode Island, it can only mean one thing, chowder and clam cakes. There are so many places where you can get these items in the Ocean State. So we decided to head to one that's been serving them up for generations, and this year, Iggy's is the winner in two counties in our state.
What began as a small clam shack in the 80s is now one of the best in the state.
Well, it started in 1989. My dad worked for the original owner. It was a 400 square foot clam shack, and we've built it up to about a 5,000 square foot facility now with over 50 items on the menu.
For 25 years, David and his staff have been serving to the masses.
Everything's cooked to order here, and we're constantly making it throughout the day, so nothing's ever hanging around. Everything comes in fresh daily, and everything's made. Like I said, the chowders are made like every hour.
There's always a line at Iggy's. That's because chowder and clam cakes are hard to resist. See what I mean?
Coming down here, waiting in line, is all part of the atmosphere. You're talking to people, you're meeting friends, you're on the beach. It's just, you know, it just gets you away from your day-to-day activities at home.
Fresh ingredients, quick service. What's not to love?
I have a fisherman's platter. I like the fish and chips and the chowder. I love their red chowder.
I like the Manhattan chowder myself.
Clam cakes and some chowder.
I just love their clam cakes.
I like the clam cakes as well, and the seafood's pretty good too.
White clam chowder and the clam cakes.
Doughboy?
Yeah, and grilled cheese.
We had the scallop and shrimp platter, and it was really delicious. Yep.
You can even get coupons for Doughboys, which are hand-dropped. Then you pick the coating.
You ready for this medley bag?
Sugar, cinnamon sugar, or confection sugar. Just might have to try all three. And that's exactly what I did.
The Doughboy shake.
Throw the sugars in a bag with hot Doughboys and shake.
Voila.
Oh, it's so good. Every sugary bite.
But don't fill up on too many. You'll want to try their top seller. Clam cakes.
And how many clam cakes do you think you can eat?
Probably 6 to 8.
That made me wonder.
This is my first clam cake of the year.
How many can I eat?
You just gotta pick them up and they just dive right in.
So I did.
This is one. I can't. That was six.
Six clam cakes for the warm-up of a Doughboy.
I love talking to people that were coming here as kids, and now they're adults bringing their kids. It's just great.
So their locations in Narragansett and Warwick are both taking home Best Clam Shack for their regions.
Always
and get this,
good.
Well, you think that they sell a lot? Well, it's 6,000 clam cakes, 5,000 Doughboys a day, plus they go through 300 gallons of chowder.
The Doughboys we could eat by ourselves, absolutely. All right, before we go to break, let's take a look at some of the other winners from Providence County. We'll be right back.
You're watching The Rhode Show Primetime Special, Rhode Island Monthly's Best of Rhode Island. A look at the very best the Ocean State has to offer, live from the Party of the Year.
To the Rhode Show Primetime Special, Rhode Island Monthly's Best of Rhode Island. This party is truly a who's who of some of the best things in the Ocean State. And I gotta tell you, you get this copy every year, you're using this as like a resource, as a go-to guide.
Absolutely is. You should carry that magazine with you in the car all the time. And we already know what a great place the Providence Performing Arts Center is to see live shows and how many great Tony Award-winning shows come here to the Providence Performing Arts Center. Let's check in with Meg to see what's going on.
Hey guys, that's right. We are having such a great time down here, and we are celebrating all the award-winning businesses around our state, but it's also a party with the cause. And this year, we got a first-hand look at where all the proceeds go to from tonight.
Funds raised at the Best of Rhode Island support Learn It to Earn It, a grant program that afforded a group of local high school students with an incredible opportunity to learn about history and the arts and then experience it.
The whole idea of the Best of Rhode Island party, it is for charity, and it's so well supported by the community from people who donate auction items, buy tickets, with the end result being that we raise money for Learn It to Earn It. So today is a great result of that because these students are able to come take part in the theater.
75 10th and 11th grade students from Hope High School took a field trip to PPAC, and what a day they had.
Yeah, it's really, really exciting, and I wanted to go because the teacher said that there was going to be like singing and dancing and puppets.
I'm really excited, and I've never seen a play before, so it's my first time.
Plus, this was no bagged lunch field trip. For their pre-show lunch, students gathered around round tables, enjoyed each other's company, and were served multiple courses.
The lunch was great. Shoot, my belly's full.
What a way to start a field trip. And they knew a live performance was a unique experience.
This was my first time seeing a play, and I watched the movie in school, War Horse, and I knew it symbolized like World War I, what was going on then. It was really cool, and I really wanted to see it as like in a play form to get like to grasp the meaning more.
In the school year, students studied World War I, and they sure did benefit from these history lessons.
Well, definitely the cavalry, the soldiers riding on horseback, because I believe that's what the play is about. They take the horse to become used in the war. So, of course, that's probably going to be a big part of this, and I'm pretty sure that the guy's going to be disappointed that they're taking this horse.
After working hard to learn the subject, what a reward for these kids.
For many, it's their first time, so they really have a unique aspect to it, and today they're getting to also listen to somebody who's been part of the stage performance, so they're learning about the background and how it all comes to be, so they're really getting a full look at it, which is exciting.
The students were just as grateful as they were excited to be there.
This is the first time I actually have a big lunch and express, like, feelings towards friends and hang out, and then right after, I mean, go see a play. I mean, I've never done that before, and it's really fantastic.
I cannot tell you how impressed I was with all of those kids. They had permanent smiles on their faces the whole time I was there. It was great. Just one more reason to love this event, Best of Rhode Island. All right, well, Michaela, back to you.
That is very cool. So glad those kids got to have that experience. Good stuff.
Absolutely. Still plenty more to come from tonight at Providence Performing Arts Center, including a look at the best burgers in the East Bay. We're dancing away, but before we head to break, let's take a look at some more winners organized by county. Welcome back to the Rhode Show Primetime Special, Rhode Island Monthly's Best of Rhode Island. We have been finding the greatest parts of the state and scouring it county by county.
Yes, we have. And as everybody knows, I am a meat and potatoes kind of guy.
That you are.
As I've said over and over again. So imagine how happy I was when I was asked to go to Billy's in Barrington and have hamburgers. And not just any hamburger, but one that was voted the best hamburger. I was very excited to be able to taste the awesomeness.
People say that if a restaurant makes a good burger, then the rest of the menu will follow.
The history of the restaurant is, the existing restaurant was Trendy's, and my sister Barbara and I were in the restaurant business back in the 80s. She called me, told me it was available. We kind of bought it spontaneously, changed the name to Billy's. It was my daughter's idea to name it Billy's. Shut it down for 8 months and rebuilt it to what it is today.
Billy's has a great menu, but the hamburger is what put it on the map.
Before we even opened, the hamburgers was a focus. I would literally have a hamburger every day. I was known as eating a hamburger for lunch daily, and we have a Billy Burger on our menu. And the two big things that before we opened a restaurant, or we used to discuss restaurants and dream of opening a restaurant, was to have a great burger.
While they wouldn't give me all the secrets, they did give me one.
And the prerequisites in our mind are, it has to be hand-packed. So our burgers come, you know, by the meat, and we pack it by hand, which gives it a more consistent type of bite and consistency where it's not compressed by a machine.
They start off with 7 ounces of local beef.
Now press it down nice and hard. Fill it out, make sure it's nice and even.
Next, it's the hot grill to cook, and the fresh Portuguese bolo buns with butter.
I bet you over 50% of our customers are real local loyal customers, meaning they come here multiple times a week. And we really cater to our regulars. We have, it's like family.
A quick flip of this burger and it's well on its way. Add cheese and their famous mushroom topping and serve.
Thank you very much, looks good.
Billy's has won the Best of Rhode Island Award since 2009. And by the looks of this burger, they deserve it.
The people that work here and our customers. I mean, because it's a really difficult business. Anyone who's in the restaurant business knows it's all about the details, all the little things, whether it's the satisfaction of the customers, whether it's having our, you know, these the right way, our table stamped, the setting, the food coming out consistently and good service.
And can I tell you, it's one of those places, if you haven't been, you need to go, because it's been a little over a week since I had one of those burgers.
And you want another one.
And I want another one. I really do.
It's one First of those, cake, then burger.
I know. It's a good life. It's one of those things that I've been thinking about the hamburger for a week now already. That's how bad it is.
We've gone to some great places, and they're all found in this issue of Rhode Island Monthly Magazine, which we mentioned before is really used as a resource.
It absolutely is. It's a great resource to have for so many people as you're looking and traveling around the state of Rhode Island.
Yep. And we want to welcome someone now who knows all about this issue. She's been on the Rhode Show before. Casey Nielsen is here with us. Good evening, Casey.
There she is.
Hello, hello. Hi, everybody.
Tell us first and foremost about the excitement about tonight.
Oh, it's so much. There's so much buildup, and now it's finally here, and, you know, there's so many people enjoying themselves, you know, having a cocktail and, you know, just kind of relaxing and dancing. I don't know if you can see any of that, but
we've even been doing a little dancing ourselves. Now, you've announced over 300 winners. Not only that, but a lot of people are seeing the cover for the first time. So let's actually let everyone at home see that cover. Explain to us what actually goes into the process of deciding on that image.
Well, we work with a really amazing design firm. It's Anderson Noon Design, and they did our cover last year, which is beautiful. But what we did was we gathered our art directors and our editors and everybody and just sat down, and we had to think of all the ideas that we could think of that were Rhode Island centric. So Dell's Cup and coffee milk and awful awfuls and paw socks and everything wonderful about the state, really, that only us Rhode Islanders would get.
I have to say, I was lucky enough to get a sneak peek of the cover even prior to tonight, and it really does capture it all. You've got the sand and the beach. We are the ocean state.
Right.
And then a whole collection of things. You can't really pick just one.
I know, it's true. There's so many amazing ones. When I'm just trying to think off the top of my head. Like I said, a lot of food-related stuff. We love our food. Stanley Burgers. I mean, come on. Who doesn't love a Stanley? We were just talking about burgers, right?
We were just talking about burgers. Will has probably gone off to go find himself another one.
Yeah.
But again, remind everyone the other kinds of winners that they can find in this issue.
Oh, so many. Really anything you can think of that you would really want to know the best of. So, you know, whether you're planning a wedding, whether you're, like, a few people are tonight, whether you're planning a wedding, whether you want to go out to dinner, an al fresco dinner, something like Cheap Eats, you know, food truck, best food truck. We have it all.
Yeah, I think that's nice of how you've even, like, narrowed down each category. It's really special. Well, Casey, thank you so much. And go off and enjoy the rest of the evening. Thank you so much. Oh, man, this has just been so much fun.
It really has.
So much excitement. Congratulations again to all of the winners out there tonight.
Lots of fun tonight. So many people who we got to see tonight who you don't see all the time. You get great food.
I think I saw everyone in the state and then some.
You get a great band, but we are not done yet. Don't forget, you can tune in tomorrow morning at 9 a.m. to The Rhode Show right here on WPRI 12 for a full recap of tonight's events.
And you can find a list of all the winners of this year's Best Of in this month's issue of Rhode Island Monthly. Thanks for joining us. Have a good night, everyone.
Have a great night. Good night.